Hey everyone, welcome to today's video. Welcome to the Gaming Daddy channel. So I thought I'd go ahead and put this in a video for you guys, and that's how to negate the bleed of the Backfire exotic SMG. Now, I appreciate you guys who hopped into my streams. If you guys do not know, I try my best to stream on weekdays and on weekends in the evenings, Central US time. So anytime from 5 p.m. in the evening, you can catch me here on YouTube streaming. And so the big question that came up was how to negate the bleed for the Backfire exotic SMG, because this SMG is so strong, they've decided to add a drawback where it makes you bleed, but it is, in my opinion, one of the more powerful SMGs in the game. Now, many have suggested using the Ninja Bike Messenger knee pads, and yes, if it will negate the bleed if you do your cover to cover. But on my testing, and I think in a video that I did, I don't know if I released the video or not, it was a problem for, you know, how consistent this parkour talent actually made it. But thanks to some of the folk that I play with, they have actually been able to, narrow down exactly how you can do this. So I'm going to show you a build that's actually from one of my buddies on here. And it basically, you know, his build basically provides you the formula on how you can actually do this very well. Now, the build does isolate three major attributes that you want on all of your gear items. So whichever combination you want, that's how you're going to go. If you're on PC, this is, somebody, Curse Gunner. He's also a very, very huge, audience member that's been watching my stuff for a long time. So he and I, we were talking about this last night on stream, but when he changed to this build, it won't populate. So if you look already, there's already something that you can see. There are two Cheska pieces, one Sokolov, one Yaw Gear, and then anything else that you kind of want to run, if you get what I mean. If you want to put two Hunter's Fury for your gloves and knee pads, I think you can do that. But the theme is every single piece is going to have hazard protection and either your critical hit chance or critical hit damage. Now, in his case, he's got the Hollow Man mask, which somebody told me was at one of the DZ vendors. So I wouldn't be surprised if I find myself actually farming to try to purchase it again. I know it was there a few weeks ago, but I don't know if it's actually been, if it's actually returned. And that's something that I want to deal with. So chest piece, hazard protection, critical hit damage. Also, while I'm going at it, there is a spot for you to be able to add a 10% bleed resistance mod as well if you want to cap that 96 or so percent. I think, according to one of my audience members, Vic, he said that the bleed caps around 96%. That's where you get almost 100% bleed resistance. And your holster is also going to have hazard protection. Man, that's strange. I thought he had like a Cheska holster, but he's gonna make sure that this is 100% maxed out with his farming, his farming capabilities. He's gonna make sure that that's a thing. And then hazard protection on his backpack. And then on the gloves, also hazard protection. And then also on the knee pad, hazard protection. When you look at the stats and, you know, look at how many, how much hazard protection he has, he's got 90% hazard protection and he has basically 100% bleed resistance. So to be very honest, if you use this combination and you go ahead and, you know, basically reload your weapon, you will not bleed at all if you actually want to do that. So that is, in my opinion, the very best way that I know negate the effect of the bleed. Now, there are other ways to do it, but to be very frank, I don't think that they actually are as attainable as a lot of people will think. There's Perfect Intimidate, which really does a very good job. I think it's a named golden chess piece. The YouTuber Kamikaze Von Doom did a video, I think a few weeks ago or a few days ago, I can't remember, but I did watch that video, and he mentioned that in order to get this chess piece, you have to defeat all the hunters that, you know, arrived with Warlords of New York. So you have to be on your patient game, or your patience game, I guess I'll say it, in order for you to farm all of these hunters. And this is the New York wall. If you notice, even my DC wall, which Warlords of New York added some to DC, I still have a few missing. I have one missing on this wall. and I'm still kind of like keeping my hunters for my Ridgeway, project. And so that's pretty much another thing. Now, if you don't really care about the bleed and you want to leverage a lot more of the damage, because yes, you can still leverage a lot of damage. Let's look at more of this, of his stats here. And I think that way we'll be able to, kind of assess, is he still getting enough crit chance? Is he still getting enough, crit damage? Well, you are. Your SMG already grants you about 21% critical hit chance. And then if you look at other things, he's got 60% critical hit chance. So he's got his crit chance maxed out, and he does have 74% critical hit damage and a decent amount of headshot damage. So this is the price that you pay if you were to do something like that. Now, YouTuber Shadow Gaming has also made a Backfire exotic build as well, where he doesn't really care for, negating the build. It's just a straight up armor and, deal breaker in terms of enemy survivability. Like, it destroys them straight up. I could show you his build, but I want you to actually go and watch his video on doing it. I watched that video twice. It's such an amazing setup, the way that he put those talents together and kind of the recommendations. And so I want you to actually go and, and see that video for yourself and basically decide how you feel you want to run it. But that's one of the really interesting things about this game. The developers have found out that when they let their weapons unleash without any drawbacks, that's when the weapon will not feel powerful once they nerf it. And so PvP is a very complex design with this game. It's for the longest time kind of put this game in a weird leash, if you get what I mean. This game has the potential to unleash fury on enemy NPCs. Remember the first Eagle Bear? It was ridiculous. Remember the first Pestilence? That was also ridiculous, in terms of, exotics. And Pestilence is more common even as a drop than even the Eagle Bear. And it was just as good, as the Eagle Bear in its early onset, because it just did a lot of work. But once it made its way into the PvP game with other combinations, it then started to become a thing where people were saying, nah, man, this is a problem. And so they've always found themselves in a position where they add a drawback to exotic weapons to not, to kind of disincentivize people from playing it, but at the same time, give others the, that want to take the risk or want to make the sacrifice, that incentive of making, use of those weapons. So I guess that's basically my video for you guys today. Thank you so much for your time and audience. And as I said, you can find me in the evening, Central U.S. time, streaming during the weekdays. I do not have a schedule because I have a life. So I don't have a streaming schedule just yet. I would love to come up with one of them. But, at the moment, I want to just keep it flexible for myself so that on the days that I can't stream because of schedule constraints, I don't. And on the days that I can, you'll see me here online on YouTube. So if you want to hit the notification bell, that way you're notified once I pop up a stream. That'll be a good way to kind of keep up. And you can come into chat and you can make fun of my trashy gameplay skills. I can't aim. I can't concentrate. Those are the fun things that people, I think, enjoy watching more than anything. Because if you're coming in here for some, high level gameplay, I will not disappoint in disappointing you. Take it easy. Peace out.